In the 1800s, countries went to war over bird droppings. That's right. Overfarming had stripped European soils of their fertility, and the nightmen who collected human waste in cities to fertilize the fields couldn't keep up with the demand for food. Guano from seabirds contained nitrogen and phosphorus, and that could enrich European farmland. And so rights to harvesting the stuff became quite contentious. Today, we can buy nitrogen-rich soils from garden stores to grow our vegetables and flowers, while farmers can buy pure nitrogen by the ton to enrich their fields. And seagulls have nothing to do with it.
So how did human beings progress from a reliance on bird droppings to the convenience of fertilizer in their shopping cart?
In 1908, the German chemist Fritz Haber came up with something extraordinary, a way of collecting nitrogen from where it is most abundant, the air. But his revolutionary method couldn't provide enough nitrogen to meet farmers' needs. It was Carl Bosch and his team of researchers and engineers at the chemical company BASF who sought to change that. After years of hard work, trial and error, and 20,000 experiments, they managed to make a machine described as having the strength of a sumo wrestler, the speed of a sprinter, and the grace of a ballerina. Today, industrial nitrogen reactors allow mass production of abundant and cheap artificial fertilizers. For the first time, mankind can get food from the air.
Talented individuals, free to pursue their interests and building off the discoveries of their predecessors, set the stage for the abundance of food we now take for granted.
Before these innovations, the Earth could feed an estimated 4 billion people before potential farmland was exhausted. Today, nearly double that live and eat from that same farmland, meaning some half of the world's population owes its existence to fertilizer produced by companies around the world.
Hey, check out these other great videos from Free to Choose Network. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get updated on episodes of New and Improved with me, Johan Norberg.